I came in with Jackie, and she and I had talked about my spare tire. You know, it's something that all men deal with, you know, and I don't mind talking about it. And, you know, it didn't matter how much I worked out, how well I ate, you know, I always had that rim right there. And the more I realized how I had struggled with that one issue right there, I said, you know what, let's get this done, you know, because every time I would look in the mirror every morning, that's what I would see. When he said, you're the perfect candidate, that was probably it for me, you know, because I wanted to know that I would have a good outcome. I didn't want to go through the emotional anxiety of thinking, okay, here I am, a guy in plastic surgery, because I've done enough, being a nurse anesthetist, done a lot of anesthesia for plastic surgeons, and quite frankly, the majority are women, but there is more and more of a population of men, you know, having that procedure done, you know, and in the back of my mind, I guess I was subconsciously thinking, you know, that's something I need done. I'm so happy, you know, with the result. Oh my goodness, yeah. So when I work out and I eat right now, I see the results that I didn't see before. You know, so. Well, in my profession, anesthesia, there's a science, a strong component of science, but there's an art to it too. Every patient is different, and I think that's the way that I perceive, you know, plastic surgery and Dr. Baker's art form is that there's a strong science component to it, but there's an undeniable artistic component to it. You won't be able to tell that I've had anything done. You know, I just hope people look at me and at the gym and say, you know, for a 58-year-old man, he looked pretty good. You know, but I would have no problems recommending Dr. Baker. I mean, wonderful staff. Dr. Baker's just a gentleman and a professional and an artist. No problem at all recommending him. No.